you basically follow what essay is. this term, this very term essay means you present something in a closed form. The translation of essay in Hindi is what? Nibandh. Nibandh means bandho. So you have to also bandho yourself. Generally you give speeches, bhasan. Don't give bhasan, give rasan. That means the first thing is that this essay, while you write, there are some boys who are appearing and they are complaining, sir, we are getting only 106, 107. The cardinal principle, as I told you earlier, that you write essays. When you start writing, the first essay would be bogus. Even if I write, that would be bogus. After 7th, 8th essay, you say, her 7 essays. Ye ishq nahi aasan, ek aag ka darya hai, aur doob ke jana. So, naturally, when you start essay, it has 5 parts. You may make it 10 parts, you may make it 5 or 7 parts, but whatever are the parts, you have to do one thing. You introduce, you expand or elaborate, Allah just write, then you analyze, then you suggest, and then you conclude. No matter whatever is the type of the essay, you have to do it. Most of you write the philosophical essays. A thing of beauty is forever. Beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder. My polite request is, please, from now on, don't attempt such essays. 40% students, they attempt these. No, it should not be done. Introduction should have at least 100 to 150 words. At least 100 to 150 words. Now, this introduction, you are very often say, sir, what we will write in this, so this 100 to 150 words you are saying, how can we write this 100 words? Two things are important. One, supposing you are in a mohalla program, in a college program, in a community program, you are the announcer, you are anchoring the program, you ask somebody to come and take the stage. Here comes Mr. So and so or Miss and so, and she is a good singer, she is a good orator. You always tell the positive things about that person. The introduction is also the positive identity of a particular issue. It's a positive. Your essay must begin with a positive note. No matter, even if it's a topic which has a negative shade. Supposing we had one essay topic, India's neighbors as angry as ever. So we have got 7 neighbors. None of them are very much satisfied with us. So, should we or should you start in a negative way? Oh, India's neighbors are not happy with India. No. You start that India at one time, after independence, led the developing or newly independent countries. We were the leaders of the non-aligned movement. We were very poor. We were producing only 48 million tons of food grains. Our per capita income was very low. It was 160th in the world. So how we became the leaders? It was because of our towering leaders, towering personalities. You start with that India in the 1950s led the non-aligned movement, and our relations with the neighbors were very cordial and harmonious. So you write in the introduction itself, we had good relations with China, Hindi Chini Bhai Bhai, we had good relations with Sri Lanka, we had good relations with Pakistan. So he said, no, we didn't. No, we had good relations. Nehru Noon Pact was there. At the end of the introduction, you write that in the last decade, some developments have taken place and our neighbors have become somewhat agitated, somewhat angry with us. So remember two things. Introduction has to be 100 words or 150 words. You give the positive things, even if the essay is very negative. Remember. The second part, in my opinion, you can just say anything. I say it, elaboration. This is the largest part of your essay. You write everything what you know correctly. Don't conjecture. If you do not know, in the introduction, you can write quotations. You can write effective words. As I said, don't write never in Hindi, never in Tamil, never in Telugu, never in any other word, but in the Roman script only. Don't ever use any Sanskrit or any Devanagari, any other script than English. That has a deduction of marks in the essay. So, as far as elaboration is concerned, generally you start with history. That's a good thing. But in history, you have a tendency to go to Indus, go to Vedic, go to even this early medieval period, even medieval period. You very often write Rani Lakshmi Bai. You do not know. Lakshmi Bai did not join the 1857 struggle on her own. People forced her. She had already written that I am with the British. So when you do not know why, and we do not know much about Vedic, that was necessary when independence struggle was going on, because we wanted to prove ourselves as worthy as the Britishers, as the Europeans. But now the situation has changed. Generally start with this very phenomena of 19th century, the coming of the British. That is the, you start the history from that period. Anything. For example, it's a must that you will get an essay topic on women. should you go to the Vedic age, you are writing Lopa Mudra, you are writing this Gargi, no, Ashwaghosha, no. You start with the middle of the 19th century. Tarabai Shinde, that Savitri Phule, Pandita Ramabai, these are the ladies from which you will start. So naturally, when you do this elaboration, you should write history, all the aspects of a particular phenomena, all the aspects of a particular phenomena, and write as much, you can go up to 500 words in this elaboration. Everything you know correctly about a particular phenomena. As far as the third part is concerned. So, very often you start criticizing a thing in the beginning itself. In the next page you write, oh, these things are wrong and these things, India has done this wrong. No. Keep it reserved for the third part. That's called analysis. Supposing you get an essay on the topic Ujjwala program for the benefit of the woman. So Ujjwala has not been a successful program. Why? Because in the program 2016 the government started it, and the program is that below poverty line women would be given subsidized the security of the refill or the cylinder. This is the program. Neither the stove is to be subsidized and nor other things are also subsidized. Only this. What happened? Government did a good thing that they gave to one credit rating agency the evaluation of this program. This is Christ, you must have heard, this is Credit Rating Institution of India Limited. This is an international company. Now, but government was in a haste, and unfortunately they started it in 2016 itself. The report of this organization came, they started it in May 2016. In July, the report was there. What the report said? If you keep the price of the refill around 450 or around 400, then the program would be successful. And if not, the program would fail. The program failed. What happened? Out of the 720 districts in India, government distributed the refills and cylinders in 715 districts. But after that, women did not buy the refills because the price was 750 and now it has been raised to 800 rupees. A negative impact was there. The supply of refills for non-BPL families, 9 cylinders per year, supply dropped because the price of the refill went up and it became 6 refills per year. So this you write where? You write in this analysis. You do not begin with, Ujjwala has failed, or Ujjwala, not even in this elaboration. It has failed. There are probably 149 programs after 2014. So Make in India program. They announced it in 2014. The program couldn't begin. We wanted to be a country like China. It is the manufacturing center of the world. Even probably 61 or 62 Indian companies are producing their commodities and products in China. We wanted the same. What the companies wanted, that you change the insurance laws. We changed it. They said you change the equity share of the companies. We did it. 86%. They also said you make the labor laws flexible labor laws. The government said, Baba, this is not possible. These mazdoors and these parties, the trade unions, they will come with their lal jhandas and they will ask their lal kile par lal nishan mang raha Hindustan. This is what. So where you write it? It is this portion when you write. You just give the real causes, that these are the causes, these are the things. So not in the beginning, not even in the elaboration, you be very careful, and this analysis would have 150 words or 100 words, but don't make it only one paragraph. Generally you write only one paragraph. Everybody writes criticism, everybody writes analysis, but somebody writes it in the end, somebody writes it in the beginning. No, the third part. Number four is that you always try to advise. That's a good thing. It's a must. You have to come out with way forward. Your suggestions. You say, sir, how could we suggest? Are Baba, you are going to be a responsible officer. You have to have one opinion. And you suggest, no, these things should be done. In Ujjwala, you write that the government must reduce the price of refills. The government must make the distribution channel more effective, and the government has to come out with different programs so the price should be less. What has happened? In Ujjwala, the women have one cylinder, but this is emergency purpose. Rest of the time, they are using that wood, they are using that cow dung, they are using that kandi, gutta, all those things. So, some visitor has come, some guest has come, and then the gas is used. So, these things you suggest, and you suggest systematically. Suggest systematically. Now, almost all of you, there is one person who is saying that I got only 106. Are Baba, you conclude. You have to, at the end, you have to write the conclusion. It's a must. The UPSC has an instruction that in every essay there must be an introduction and there must be a conclusion. You simply ask, sir, what we write, sir, in introduction, in conclusion, you are saying that 120 to 150 words. Wow, how this? Almost, so we can say, you write one paragraph. No, this is, you summarize, other than the introduction, you summarize the elaboration, you summarize the this analysis, you summarize the way forward in brief, systematically. Again, this conclusion is the portion when you conclude with as effective as possible, as effectively as possible. So, naturally, no matter whatever is the essay type, you have to follow this pattern. These five parts can be divided into seven parts. These five parts can be divided into 10 parts or others, but you have to begin, introduce, you have to elaborate, you have to analyze, you have to give way forward or suggestions, and no need of writing way forward, no need of writing elaboration, no need of writing this introduction. You write, and next thing is that the essays generally can be classified. Some essays, as I told you, are philosophical essays. Those are philosophical essays. My polite request again is, please don't attempt those. Those are difficult things. Most of you, you think that, oh, I can write it, I'll write it. And then you give a go, long bhasan, 1000 word or 1200 words. So when this bhasan is worthless, you get 90 to 115 marks. That's the average mark for essay. This is what is. The second essay is, that's very often called as the synthetic essay. You have to combine many things. You have to most of the issues, should India go for total privatization? There are health and education sector. India is trying to give these sectors to the private sector. But there is a very strong debate and opposition to this. Amartya Sen is saying, no, this is bad. Jidrej is saying, this is bad. Then this our Jagdish Bhagdwati says, no, unless and until you privatize, you cannot. These essays are synthetic essays. You have to write very clearly in the elaboration the arguments for private sector, then the arguments for public sector. The arguments for private sector, the arguments for public sector. There is no escape from that. The third essay is very often it is called as descriptive essay. Supposing there is an essay on tourism. Tourism, very often you can and just expect the tourist. So, what you do, that yes, you will the analysis, you will say that there is a problem of law and order, there is a problem of these agents, not problems of hotels, all the third part. But basically, tourism essay has to describe things in detail. Just give the description. Whatever you know about Kashmir, whatever you know about Darjeeling, whatever you know about Rajasthan, you remember Rajasthan is the state which attracts the highest number of tourists every year in India. This is a fact. As far as internal tourism is concerned or external tourism is concerned, India is very low as far as Bahri tourists are concerned. We are on the 13th position as far as the latest reports are concerned. So Economic Survey of India has given whole 3 pages on tourism. What are the possibilities? What are the drawbacks? Read those things. The fourth essay is generally analytical essay. Analytical essay. Those essays demand that you should be very much clear about the different economic things. If it's a question on international relations, the principal IR, you must know. International relations are based on 5 cardinal principles. Number one is the geopolitical situation of a country. No country, the country is very powerful, but if it is landlocked, then it is in a bad position. So this geopolitics is the first condition. The second condition is the economic resources. China could very easily realize, so long our economic resources are not very high, we cannot do anything. Mao Zedong said America is a paper tiger. But the kind of policies he followed from 1959 Congress were not helping China. Then Deng Xiaoping came. 79, 70, he came in 78. He realized, though, Are Baba, the purpose of the cat is to catch the mouse. The color of the cat might be red, the color of the cat might be blue, let whatever color it is. But after all, you should have the capacity to catch the mouse. And then it started. You remember, in 1970, the GDP of India was almost 3 million or 4 million more than China's GDP. Today, their GDP is $11.6 trillion and our GDP is $2.6 trillion. Vajpayee ji went to China in 1978, probably, if I remember correctly, as a foreign minister. At that time, China was not very developed. But even at that time, he realized that we have to make friends with China. They have got the potentiality, we have got the potentiality. But China, since has been a rogue country from the very ancient periods. Whatever you use, almost half of the things are Chinese. You are using this pen, China. You are using this paper, China. So you are using this shoe from China. But these are the, you are using gunpowder from China. You are using the guns from China. We have also got certain things. The big zero, it has been invented by us, the Indians. We were masters in mathematics. We are still masters in mathematics. So naturally, but we could not develop much. So the purpose is that you analyze very critically. In economic cases, you have to be very clear-cut knowledge. What is the rate of growth? What are the capitalization of different companies? What our big companies, corporates are doing? This you must. Now, the next thing is that after all, how you write the issue or how you prepare for writing the issues? In your rooms, you buy two copies, rather thick. Let the paper be not very bad, well, you can just in which you can write. One copy for your essay writing, another copy for your material collection. Collect whatever material you can collect. Remember, the bland essays get marks 110, 115. Essay should have two compulsory things. Remember, these are two essential. So when you say that in South India they take food, so without sambar, generally the food is not complete. Only with rice, you can't do it. The Chinese can eat rice and tea, nothing else. It's like that Far East and the South East practice. We want in North India dal, bhat, sabji and some roti also. In South India, rice and sambar, at least that's it. Then the sabji is there and other things. So, essay has also two essential components. Number one is, as I said, this is structure. Without a structure, your essay cannot get good marks. No matter. So, they say, sir, you are a very strict examiner. No. Any examiner would be giving only that. 40 marks, 40%. Without a structure, oh, you have written. When you come out from the exam hall, likh diya aaj. When you get the marks, this examiner is a bekoof. he is an idiot. Remember, my dear friend, every essay copy, every paper is judged by two examiners. And no examiner is allowed to point even a single drop anywhere. Your front pages are torn out, you are given a symbol, and two persons judge your essays. Never complain that the examiner has been a brute person. He does not know who is this examiner. So why should be giving less marks and more marks? The second thing is that this essay must have this sambar or this dal or this information. As much correct information as you can give, as much correct information as much as you can give. So, supposing there is one compulsory topic every year, that topic is women. Because you say that Dil De Chuke Sanam, there was a song, Kudiyon Ka Hai Jamana. Really, it's a fact. What has happened after 1950, particularly American women have launched very serious movement. And you remember from 1981, when the word gender developed as word for woman, then in 1983 the World Bank came out with a statement that every development program must have the agenda of woman. You got an essay in 2016. Those are the words of United Development Organization, UNDP, United Nations Development Program. That very sentence was given, third page sentence is there. If development is not engendered, then development endangered. Their statement is this. So, write about this woman. You introduce. Supposing we gave the topic, the performance of women sports persons must be saluted. And just in the next paragraph you are saying, oh, they have got many roadblocks. No, yaar, women are marching. You write all the positive things. Only at the analytical part you write that there is patriarchy, there is this tradition, there is this religion. There are other things. Write about history, that it was Savitri Phule, it was Tarabai Sinde, it was Pandita Ramabai. They started the movement. You remember all the three eminent women initiators and pioneers, they have all come from Maharashtra. And it is the contribution of the Rashtradharma movement from a 13th century that led to it. So you start from there. Give in that part that women have four perspectives. One is religious perspective. Another is the liberal perspective, the capitalist liberal, our Gandhi Baba. Gandhiji was not for equal man and woman. Gandhiji said, their primary concern is family and children. And then if she gets the time, she should come for public work. He has been criticized by many ladies. Then the third is feminism. And the fourth is gender. Gender means Durga, power too. Feminism is equality in all respects. But gender means give power to women. Why we give this reservation to women in panchayats and local bodies? Earlier, in 1993, it was 33%. In 2009, they made it 50%. In parliament, Sarad Yadav might be saying, oh, Bal Katti. the Bal Kattir would be given this reservation in the legislatures and in the parliament, you take it in writing. So you give this information in the essay. So remember, don't write bland essays, and this is the reason I say that you have to collect information. Read Hindu, read newspapers, those newspapers which come out with information. Three things as far as your essay is concerned. Number one is that when you start or you just see the essay topics, in 50% of the cases, you do not understand the meaning of the essay. And then you start writing. Please take 10 minutes, even if the essay topic is given here, please take 10 minutes to read the essay topic, to understand the essay topic. Mind you, my dear friend, in 2016, at least 30% of the students could not understand the meaning of this endangered and endangered. They couldn't understand. They, kya jata hai, 10 minute lagaye, theek se dekho, tab ish karo. Wo hai, acche se. 50% of the students, they do not understand the meaning of the issue. Friend, this is a correct thing. So naturally, so next step is you must do rough work. You think, no, it is a wastage of time. No, it is not wastage of time. You give 10 to 15 minutes in rough work, and then your rough work is like rough. हुसैन की कला रहती है नहीं साफ साफ थोड़ा रफ वर्क आप रफ देखो और लिखो दिस इज अ थर्ड पॉइंट अरे एसे सीरियस राइटिंग व्हाई इफ एनीबडी सेज दैट योर एसे शुड बी इन फ्लो नो ही इज रॉन्ग आवर माइंड इज वेरी फास्ट नो कंप्यूटर इन द वर्ल्ड नो मैटर हाउ एवर दिस आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस डेवलप अभी तक कोई कंप्यूटर इस खोपड़ी का बराबरी नहीं कर सकता इट्स वेरी फास्ट एंड योर हैंड इज नॉट एज फास्ट सो राइटिंग इन अ फ्लो इज अ बैड थिंग राइट स्लो वन थिंग मोर मेनी पीपल डू नॉट हैव गुड लैंग्वेज अरे जाय जहन्नम में लैंग्वेज कोई फर्क नहीं आप थोड़ी मिल्टन हो जाओगे शेक्सपियर हो जाओगे टी एस एलियट हो जाओगे एक वर्किंग जैसी भी इंग्लिश जैसी भी हिंदी जैसी भी तेलुगु आती है उसमें लिखना दूसरी बात सम पीपल राइट वेरी इनलिजिबली राइटिंग खराब है जाने दे जहन्नम धीरे धीरे लिखेंगे This is written that you should not and must not write more than 1200 words. Is there anything that you should not write 800 words in essay? And I can tell you that these were Jindali, they are not. I asked Jindal not to crease 800 words. Probably he has got 160 or 150. I was giving him 95 marks, 100 marks, this was my... So when he came, sir, you are very much angry on me and hum ka hum to tum se dushmani hum ho. Arey bhaiya, I don't know your name. Many of them complain, no, no, we are not getting this from... This year there is some kakkad is there. Humne yaar kyon us par khakwate ho? Achha likhoge, achha marks aaye. There is another thing also. You very often ask, should we give the diagrams? Yes. Should we give charts? Yes. Should we give mapping if international relations, should we draw the map? Yes, map should be almost, this indicate this, this is China, this is Thailand, this is Borneo, this is Indonesia, this much of this is there. But irrelevant things, you know some map and you are trying to give it. It's a galat. Irrelevant quotations. You are writing about India's neighbor as angry as ever, and you are starting with Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. अरे यार irrelevant नहीं लिखो. इसीलिए ऐसा है कि अब तो मैंने सारी बातें बता दी हैं. थोड़ा हो जाए, आपको 300 words में लिखना है. यहीं पर अभी 20 मिनट का टाइम है, 20 मिनट का टाइम है. 2 मिनट और मैं बोल दूँ कि साहब आप यहाँ रफ नहीं करोगे, बिकॉज यू हैव टू राइट ओनली 300 words, नॉट मोर देन 300 words, नॉट मोर देन 300 words, एंड यू हैव टू राइट ऑन द टॉपिक वुमेन ऑन द मार्च. In India, 300 words. आप 20 मिनट का टाइम है, उससे ज़्यादा नहीं, किसी भी हालत में नहीं. This is 3:25 in my watch, and you have to cover it 3:45. लिख लो यार, आप ही बोल रहे थे मेरे ख्याल से कि 105 नंबर आता है ना, यार लिख लो कि कौन थे आप साहब. अच्छा, somebody was there. चलो लिखो, देख लिया जाता है कितने पानी में हो, वो ही पता चल जाएगा. 20 मिनट चक दे इंडिया का, ये 70 मिनट, सो दीज 20 मिनट्स. वुमेन ऑन द मार्च इन इंडिया, यू हैव टू राइट 300 words, राइट 300 words. जिसका 5 मिनट में ख़त्म हो जाए वो भी आ जाओ मेरे पास. यू कैन राइट इन 5 मिनट्स, इफ़ यू कैन राइट 300 words इन 5 मिनट्स. I'm really surprised. You are preparing for UPSC for how many years? You have started just in which March you have decided, month you have decided you have to appear for UPSC. कब decide किया? अभी decide नहीं किया. चलिए, आपने when you decided last year? You appeared last year in the prelims. You didn't think that there is an essay of 250 marks. You remember? So probably you had written 1 or 2 essays. No, you written. कब से तो हैं? Last year you had given prelims. So why didn't you just think that I have to just give this essay thing also? You thought? No. अच्छा, सो हैव यू अपीयर्ड इन प्रीलिम्स? प्रीलिम्स हैव गिवन. एक्चुअली आई थिंक दैट आई हैव द मिसफॉर्चून ऑफ सक्सेसफुल यूपीएससी. I was selected for IAS, but I opted for teaching. The second thing that I had the misfortune of being an examiner of UPSC also. That's very mechanical work. But what I think after seeing your copies, as far as the first attempt is concerned, Your attempt is very good. I have given the highest mark 5 and the lowest mark 4. She didn't write the only, and probably he wrote, he started it very well, but he couldn't just pursue it in a very good manner. Remember, strategically, I think that you are doing something wrong, because you plan. Essay has 250 marks, so this essay should also have this time for 250 marks. As someone, when I entering this class, was saying that I am not getting good marks. Most of you, I know that you will commit that mistake. Structure is the most important drawback you suffer. And all of you, barring I think two students, they have followed the right structure. This is very normal. Whenever you are just doing this, in the beginning you will not follow the structure. This comes just by practice. Unless and until you write 5 essays, you will not be able to master that structure. And unless and until you master that structure, you cannot get more than 140 marks. You will definitely get 150 if your information and structure both are correct. Nobody can stop it. But two things, bland essays, you have got very good structure, but then that had no information, then probably you will not get good marks. I can tell you that there is no fixed topic that from these topics essays would come. But prepare on 9 topics, remember, on 9. First is woman. Second is administrative reforms and Indian constitution and constitutional problems. Fourth is economic issues. Fifth, economic policy. Sixth is culture, sports, and anything, dance, film. Seventh is international relations. International relations. Eighth is the disputes, that means river water or regions. And ninth is on the deficiencies, handicap, LGBT, all these things, all issues. Article 377, since it is related to some kind of a problem area, this problem area may come. But this is not the whole thing. The essay may come outside. But mostly essays are from these topics. Prepare everything as far as women is concerned. So, laws are passed, child labor. So these are with this constitution, these are with these laws. So remember, I begin with this thing that no matter whatever I sermonize or give as upadesh, you will not follow unless and until you write. And you remember that examiner is not your enemy. It is true that you are not able to write even 300 words. Only there are 4 students who wrote more than 300. Only 4. That means spontaneously you are not able to write, because most of you have come from engineering background. How many from engineering background? But here I out of 27, you are 27 here, I have just allowed one to go. From commerce background, management and commerce, none. Oh, you are from commerce, management. and from the social sciences, rest all are from social science. Yeah. Then those people who are from social sciences, they shouldn't have this difficulty of writing the essays. But remember, as I told you in the beginning itself, that you have to give as much time, that means 250 marks time. Your optional has 500 words, 500 marks, so give more. Now, your other papers, GS, the 4 papers of GS, give the marks. In fact, in which paper or in whichever subject you are more adept, you read more. But that, what is your weak point? Essay is the weak point for most of you. So, not every day, but at least in a week, 2 days, you write. You write. You start with 200 words, then go on 300 words, then write 500 words, then write more. But all these things, informations, probably you cover in your GS papers. We don't have to give any exams now, but since it is our interest that we want to, the same is true about the people who examine your copies, essay copies. 50% are teachers, but some of the journalists are also essay examiners. Ex-police officers, ex-IS officers, they constitute 30% of your examiners as far as the essay paper is concerned. This draws largest number of 4 different fields. Now, as I told you, you did not pick up the meaning of the woman on march in India today. March means gone up. Why are you starting with history? Why are you starting with, Are Baba, you have written this Pratibha Patil, you have written this P.V. Sindhu. First paragraph should have this name, P.V. Sindhu, Hima Das, Saina Nehwal. Start with March. This is the first tactics of essay. So, but my bhasan will not do. You write. And as far as, अरे मेरा तो कोई teacher ही नहीं देखता है, no man. Never you examine your own essay. Everybody thinks I have good write. Nobody is a good examiner of his own performance. हर आदमी 30 mark खान है. You must write and give it to your friend. The seat and give marks, but never try to evaluate yourself, your own performance or your own essay. You say, sir, nobody is there. No, no. You see others' copy or others' essay and give your essay to somebody else. So, start writing, make a copy. 250 marks is not a very as a joke, it's something very important. When even 1 mark counts, your essay paper counts. And so have a copy in your room of your essay, write 300 words, 400 words, 500 words, then 1000 words. Normally, I would advise you not to go more than 1000 words. You are allowed to write 1200 words, write 1000. If you are probably, I didn't find barring one that writing was bad. Yes, don't give any attention to language. Your language would improve after 10 essays. Nobody can stop this. You write 10 essays and if your language does not improve, you complain that no sir, my language and all, it would definitely improve. So I think from now on you should start writing. If any questions you have, you can just raise any questions. Yeah.
So there is some trend that we should start with some storyline that we have to start some actors with the beginning. So what
are actually what happens that you are guided, inspired, influenced by what my observation is generally five sources. Number one, your friends who may not have done themselves good, but they are the greatest advisors. Advice is the most common thing in India. You get advices. Number two, now on the net or the YouTube has many of the speeches and experiences our ex-students. They have given their experiences, yes. Everybody tries to justify himself. There's nothing wrong. That's human nature. The third, there are some very famous teachers of SA. And you just, wow, he said this. Then the fourth is, there are some essay books, essay writing books. From that, you are also influenced. Now, five is that very often you think, I need not any advice, I myself is enough, and then I can just write anything. So, these are the things. My advice is, that you start writing essays, and if you start writing essays after 5, 6, 7, you will say, sir, this is so taxing thing. Yes, essay writing is the bogus thing. Many of you do not have writing tendencies, but you know that even in the optional you have to write, even in the GS papers you have to write. There is no escape from writing. As far as his questions are concerned, should we start with the quotation? Arey Baba, aapko yaad hi nahi. This was your question. What was your question?
There's some actor that, as far as the example of climate change, should have two actors who have suffered anything from bad from climate change.
Yeah, so, why not? Why not? You can, there is a girl, Reena, and who suffered in this, but mind it. You should be very clear about certain things. Don't go by newspapers. No, Hindu is a newspaper which has got even the Megasese Award. Sainath was a Megasese Award winner. And even now there are many others who are very good writers there. So that apart, rest of the newspapers are not up to the mark. Don't go by the newspapers. For example, we had that essay in our regular courses, climate change. And most of them wrote that these Kerala floods are a result of climate change. What is your opinion? It's not climate change. Chennai rains are a result of climate change. But as far as Kerala is concerned, it is unorganized building construction, tourist resorts, all these buns in an unplanned or unscientific manner. The climate change is not, the average rainfall is not this time more in Kerala. That's the rain, average rainfall. But this time, the rains fell just in a very short span. So it's not climate change. It is human construction which has led to these floods. So this is the thing, you should be very, very clear. Even in this essay, what happened, that you could not understand the meaning of march. And why you should start with this history? Why should you start with that India is patriarchal? Start that Pratibha Patil, start that Hima Das, that these are the shining, glorious examples. Any other question? So as far as your writing is concerned, you write letters, love letters. Now this is not the zamana of love letters, because now there is net, there is mobile. You simply write that MMS, MMS and all the SMS, all those things you just mail. So, but in whatever writing you are interested, do that. If you have a good paper is this ethics, write on that. If your good paper is history, write on history. Write on the character of this Dara, write on the character of Aurangzeb, write on the character of Akbar, write on the character of Ashok, write on the character of anybody, this our Tarabai in the Maratha leader, whom I always admire more than Shivaji. So she was a woman and a very, very skilled administrator in Maharashtra, Maratha leader. So anything, where you are interested, you write on that. Anything, any other questions? Yeah.
So in the elaborate aspect of this essay, should we not go touch the post-pre-independence thing at all, or should we just focus upon the modern movement, 21st century?
No, here, as far as history is concerned, I told you earlier that you start with mid-19th century. Any question on women, because you will have a topic on women, nobody can stop it. So if there is scope of right, history is not a must, but if there you are writing history, despite my advice, two persons have written about Vedic things have been mentioned. Arey Baba, we do not know much about that conjecture as far as the Vedic thing is concerned. So history you start with 1850 onwards. Generally, in certain questions you can start with 1850 onwards. Those who are history students, they must have read the book or are aware of the book of Shekhar Bandyopadhyay, India from Palasi to Partition. India from Palasi to Partition. That's a good book. If you have got time, read it, because that would help you in your GS first paper, that would help you in that GS third paper also, because it gives certain grounding on different aspects. So naturally, and you have to read three things. Economic survey, must read. India, must read. And the Constitution of India, you must read. Every day, Article 377 is not constitution, it is IPC, Indian Penal Code. But this time this 377 is a debatable thing, it's an issue. Large number of people, despite the fact, scientifically it has been proved, neither lesbianism, nor this gay, nor this bisexuality, nor this transgender, not the fifth thing, queer sexual behavior, everything is normal. Psychologists, scientists have proved it by their researches. Nothing is unique, nothing is something of a disease, everything is normal. Transgenders, we have thrown them out from our society. They do not get health facilities. So, whenever something happens, the judgment on this 377 by Y.B. Chandrachud this time was the best judgment. You read it. You say, why should you go? Arre Baba, jab UPSC dene ka soch liya hai, to kuch karna hai padega. Aag ka darya hai, aur wo, the way you are writing, I think that you are still not taking UPSC very seriously. So with these words, I don't think that anybody has got any questions. Any questions? Any questions? I think that I wish you all the best. But my polite request is, if your essay does not have a structure and if your essay does not have information, you are not doing, will not do good. So please collect information and please start writing essay. Thank you very much.